Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 17th of February. Police arrest wanted accused in India's Red Fort violence case recovers two swords. Taliban calls on US to pull out troops from Afghanistan in open letter. And protesters demand release of jailed journalist in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And now for all the details. A delegation of foreign envoys arrived in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday for a two-day visit to assist development in the Union Territory post the abrogation of Article 370. The 20-member delegation includes envoys of the European Union and nations in the Middle East and Africa.
A 20-member foreign delegation, including envoys of the European Union and nations in the Middle East and Africa, arrived in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday for a two-day visit to assess development in the Union Territory. The diplomats on the first day of their visit interacted with locals in Budgam district, met members of political parties and the members of newly elected district development councils. During their trip, they would be briefed about the security situation as well as law and order challenges in the region. This visit assumes significance as the local body elections were recently conducted successfully in the Union Territory after the abrogation of Article 370 in August 2019.
Kyunki abhi hame ek hi mahina ho gaya aur ek hi mahine ke andar mein hamare district development council ko ye ek ऐजाज मिला कि हमें इतनी बड़ी फॉरेन डेलीगेट्स के साथ इंटरेक्शन करने का मौका मिला और अपने जो भी यहाँ पर डेवलपमेंट के हवाले से जो स्कीम्स हैं हमारे जो कुछ किया है या जो कुछ करना बाकी है उस हवाले से उनके साथ हमने इंटरेक्शन किया.
Two batches of foreign diplomats had earlier visited Jammu and Kashmir last year to assess development in the region claimed by Indian government post the abrogation of Article 370.
Delhi police has arrested one of the main accused in connection with the violence at the Red Fort complex on Republic Day in the Indian capital. Two swords were also recovered from the possession of the accused. On January 26, tens of thousands of protesting farmers had clashed with the police in New Delhi during a tractor parade that was called by farmer unions to reiterate their stance on the center's farm laws.
Delhi Police Special Cell has arrested Marinder Singh, one of the main accused in connection with the violence at the Red Fort complex on India's Republic Day. Two 4.3 feet khandas or swords were recovered from his house. Marinder Singh alias Moni, a 30-year-old AC mechanic, was wanted by the Delhi Police after his video surfaced from January 26 tractor rally organized by farmer unions protesting against the three farm laws, where he was seen swinging swords at the Red Fort. The police said that Singh was doing the act with an intent to motivate, radicalize and energize the violent anti-national elements, indulging in brutal attack on police persons on duty with swords and damaging the historical monument on Republic Day. Meanwhile, NSUI, the students' wing of opposition Congress Party in Indian capital, marched on the streets and raised slogans as they condemned the arrest of 22-year-old environmentalist Disha Ravi on Wednesday. Disha, an activist linked to Swedish climate change campaigner Greta Thunberg, was arrested over the weekend on charges of sedition and she remains in police custody. Disha had allegedly created and shared a toolkit in support of the farmers' agitation against the center's new agriculture laws. Meanwhile, a Mumbai court on Wednesday granted bail to Disha Ravi's associate Nikita Jacob, a lawyer based in Mumbai. Police had sought Nikita's arrest for allegedly working together with Disha Ravi on a toolkit or a document that it said was used to foment violence during a mass protest by farmers in Delhi last month. But Jacob petitioned a court in Mumbai to stop the police from carrying out her own arrest warrant.
In news from Afghanistan, The Afghan Taliban, in an open letter to the American public, has urged the United States to abide by its commitments to withdraw U.S. forces from Afghanistan in accordance with the U.S.-Taliban peace deal signed last year.
Taliban's leader Mullah Abdullah Abdul Ghani Baradar, in an open letter to the American public, has urged the United States to abide by its commitments to withdraw U.S. forces from Afghanistan by May. The Taliban senior leader has also said that the group is committed to act upon the U.S.-Taliban peace agreement, stating that he is confident that the Afghans will finally agree on an Islamic system and sustainable peace and security through a political settlement. In the letter, the Taliban also said they will respect women's rights in accordance to the Islamic principles. The United States and the Taliban had signed a peace deal last February in Doha, in accordance to which the U.S. agreed to withdraw its troops from Afghanistan in exchange for security guarantees from the insurgent group. Meanwhile, the Afghan National Security and Defense Forces are making the fight against the Taliban among their main priorities, local media reports suggest. The Taliban has so far not commented, but the Afghan Ministry of Defense has said that the Taliban will face severe consequences if the group insists on war and violence.
Moving on to news from Pakistan. A six-day multinational naval exercise hosted by Pakistan ended in the Arabian Sea on Tuesday, with the participation of some 45 countries, including the US, Russia, China and Turkey. The navies conducted exercises to gather against terrorist and piracy threat in the maritime domain. Pakistan's Navy took part in a six-day multinational exercise aimed at improving security at sea, which ended on Tuesday. Around 45 navies, including those of the United States, Britain and China, took part in the Arabian Sea exercises. The navies conducted exercises to gather against terrorist and piracy threat in the maritime domain. The drill, a biannual affair since 2007, ended with the closing ceremony attended by Pakistan's President Arif Alvi, the country's three services chiefs, ministers and foreign diplomats, according to a Pakistan Navy statement.
The motto of this exercise is Together for Peace. So the purpose of this exercise is to bring regional and extra-regional navies on one platform and then conduct exercises to enhance the interoperability and in addition to counter the terrorist threat and the crimes which are happening in the maritime domain.
This is the first time Russia has joined a military drill with NATO members in a decade. The last such time was in 2011 in the Bold Monarch 2011 exercise off the coast of Spain. Moving on. Scores of locals recently held a protest demanding release of journalist and rights activist Tanveer Ahmed, who has been lost in jail for nearly 6 months for removing Pakistani flag from a public place in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. The case has highlighted brutality on political activists who have been resisting against Pakistan's illegal occupation of the region.
People in Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently held a protest demanding immediate release of journalist and rights activist Tanveer Ahmed, who has been languishing in jail for around 6 months for removing Pakistani flag from a popular public place in the illegally occupied region. Tanveer Ahmed, a British Kashmiri, was detained by police in August 2020 and charged with different sections following his challenge to what he calls an oppressive establishment that has crushed people's rights and has stifled freedom of expression in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. The protesters demanded a fair trial must be initiated at the earliest in the case, as they raised pro-freedom slogans and warned of intensified protests. During his arrest in August 2020, Tanveer Ahmed was beaten and mishandled by security forces, highlighting brutality on political activists and residents who have been resisting against Pakistan's illegal occupation and demanding Pakistani forces and other officials to leave the region.
In news from Bangladesh, a court in Bangladesh on Tuesday sentenced to death 5 members of an Islamist militant group for 2015 killing of a US blogger critical of religious extremism. Muslim-majority Bangladesh saw a string of deadly attacks between 2013 and 2016 targeting bloggers, secular activists and religious minorities.
A court in Bangladesh sentenced to death 5 members of an Islamist militant group on Tuesday for killing a US blogger critical of religious extremism 6 years ago. Avijit Roy, a US citizen of Bangladeshi origin, was hacked to death by machete-wielding assailants in February 2015 while returning home with his wife from a Dhaka book fair. His wife and fellow blogger Rafida Ahmed suffered head injuries and lost a finger. The court also jailed one man for life in the attack. The 6 men convicted on Tuesday belong to the Al-Qaeda-inspired domestic militant group Ansarullah Bangla Team, which police say was behind the murders of more than a dozen secular activists and bloggers. Nazrul Islam, defense lawyer for the 6 men, said they would appeal against the sentences in the higher court. Muslim-majority Bangladesh saw a string of deadly attacks between 2013 and 2016 targeting bloggers, secular activists and religious minorities claimed by Islamic State or Al-Qaeda-aligned groups.
After Sri Lanka, Nepal has now responded to a recent statement made by India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party leader and Tripura State Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb, in which he quoted Interior Minister Amit Shah as saying that the party would soon form its government in the Himalayan and the island neighbours. Replying to a Twitter user who shared a news report on Deb's remarks, Nepal's Foreign Minister Pradeep Gyawali said formal objection has been already conveyed. Reports suggest that Nepal's ambassador to India, Nilambar Acharya, has already conveyed the government's official objection to Indian officials. Deb, while addressing the party workers in Agartala, recalled a meeting with Shah, who was then BJP national president, and during his visit to the state told party leaders that the BJP would establish rule in other regional countries as part of Atmanirbhar South Asia initiative. On Monday, Sri Lanka's Election Commission Chairman Nimal Punchiheva shot down reports saying the country's electoral law does not permit such an arrangement. A dog show was recently organized in India's Siliguri city, which attracted more than 120 breeds of canines from around the country. According to the organizer, the event was aimed at giving dog lovers a chance to explore various varieties of breeds and also enhance the owner's affection for the animals.
More than 120 breeds of canines won the hearts and ruled at a dog show held recently in eastern India. Show organizer Abhijit Bonick said various breeds of dogs were part of the show whose owners brought them from neighboring states. Breeds like poodles, Siberian husky, German golden retriever, among others, were the main stealers of hearts at the show.
बहुत जगह से डॉग आता है हम लोगों का सभी तो हम लोग सब डॉग नहीं जानते हैं कौन सा डॉग है क्या है तो यहाँ आने के बाद सब हजारों किस्म का डॉग दिखाई जाता है उसका कौन सा प्रजाति है तो इसीलिए हम लोग ये डॉग शो किया है दूसरा है कि डॉग शो करने से आदमी का मन में भी डॉग के बारे में और चाहत होगा ये हम लोगों का ये इसी के कारण हम लोग
तो जो मुंह में जो हमारे कुछ बोल नहीं पाता है जानवर को भी हम इज्जत देना चाहिए हम इंसान है तो उनको भी छोटा नज़र से नहीं देखना चाहिए ऐसे शो में लाने से वो भी कुछ एंटरटेनमेंट अपना मन से करेंगे तो हमारे पे जो पेट जो है और जो है ना हमारा जो इंसान के साथ जो कम्युनिकेशन बढ़ जाएगा उनके साथ में और पेट्स यहाँ लाने से वेराइटीज मिल जाएगा देखने को मिल जाएगा उनका जो क्या क्या एटीट्यूड है डॉग का जो एटीट्यूड है वो भी दिखने को मिलेगा अच्छा लगा हमने भी सिलीगुड़ी में पहली बार हुआ है
According to the organizers, such shows give people a chance to explore various varieties of breeds and also enhance the owner's affection for their animals.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Sous subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.